The vast majority of models in Maya have this question. Is it possible to work in real-world scale in Maya? I have seen forums and discussions in the internet that say it's impossible. While some say it's possible, what they do is have a reference image underneath the model and just kind of trace it. This might work well if you're doing something other than architectural rendering, but for architectural rendering, you have to be precise unless you want to have some very small, ridiculously looking building. So to answer the question, is it possible to work in real-world scale in Maya? Yes, you can 100% model in real-world scale in Maya. Let's see how.
I am now going to create a 3D model out of a simple 2D plan. By doing this, you can learn how to work with real-world measurements. The first thing we have to do is check our working units. To do so, go to Windows menu, Settings and Preferences, Preferences, and under Settings, make sure you have set this to centimeter. I always have this set to centimeter, even though I'm working in a different unit. And I strongly suggest you that you also set this to centimeter. The reason why I say this is because all the simulations and animations in Maya needs to have centimeter as its unit. So if you change this, you might have trouble at later stages of your project. I have set this to centimeter, but still, I'm going to work in feet and inches. To do so, I'm going to manipulate the grids. Now hit save, go to display menu, and hit the square beside grid. Now set length and width to 1 units, grid lines every 30.48 units, and set subdivisions to 12. The reason why I have given this 30.48 units is because 1 feet equals 30.48 centimeters. I want to have one main grid line for every 1 feet and one sub-grid line for every 1 inch. Since 12 inches make 1 feet, I have given this 12. Now hit apply and close. We can check the measurements in our scene using the measure tool. You can see we have set this right, and we are now all set to start our modeling. Let's model a simple room of 10 feet by 10 feet interior dimensions. The wall thickness here is 9 inches, so let's start with a cube of 9 inches by 9 inches dimensions. I have used grid snap by pressing and holding X key in my keyboard. For now, I'm going to give a random height. Now select the face in the right and extrude. Now we want to move this face in X direction for 10 feet. One way to do this is to use the grid, but counting your grids can be tedious if you want to move for a longer distance. So we are going to use a second method called relative movement. We want to move this face to 10 feet in X direction, and remember 10 feet equals 304.8 centimeters. In the command line, type move space hyphen r space 304.8 space 0 space 0. Here hyphen r denotes that this is relative movement. To know more about relative and absolute movement in Maya, visit my blog. You can find the link in the description below. Now hit enter, and we have now moved this to 10 feet in X direction. Use grid snap to make sure you're right over the grid. We are now going to start creating this wall. So let's extrude this face and move this 9 inches in X direction. Now select this face and extrude. This time, we want to move 10 feet in the negative Z direction. So once again, we are going to use the command line. Type move space hyphen R space 0 space 0. And since we are going to move in negative Z direction, start with minus 304.8. We have now moved this to 10 feet in the negative Z direction. To make sure you are over the grid, use the grid snap. Once again, extrude this face to 9 inches. Now we are going to extrude this face to 10 feet in the negative X direction. We can use the command line now, but it is much easier if you use the vertex snap. Once again, use vertex snap to create the thickness of the wall. Now let's make this a closed wall. I select this face and delete. Select the face in the opposite. Extrude. Use vertex snap. And delete this face. This way, we can have a proper polygon. Edit mesh and merge. We have now completed the walls. Let's give this room a height of 10 feet. Select the vertices and use grid snap to move it to a height of 10 feet. Insert two edge loops in the outside and in the inside and give both a height of 7 feet. These lines are going to be the top of your door and window. Now we have a window 1 feet away from this wall. So let's insert an edge loop. And use grid snap to position it 1 feet away from this wall. Let's insert another edge loop. And let's position this 3 feet away from the former one. Now we are going to delete the faces that are not necessary. Select the edges here. Hit extrude and use vertex snap to close this hole. Select the polygon, edit mesh, merge. We now have a proper polygon and we have made the hole for the door. We now have a window right in the middle of this wall. The width of the window is 5 feet, so let's start making this window. Let's make two edges for the bottom of the window. I connect these two edges, and similarly, I make an edge for the inside of the window. Let's select these edges and give it a height of 3 feet from the ground. Now let's connect these two edges. This will be the middle of this wall. And similarly, do it for the inside. The width of the window is 5 feet, which means it is 2.5 feet away from the middle line on either sides. So let's connect these edges on either side and do it on the inside too. Let's position these edges 2.5 feet away from the middle one. Use grid snap to do that. Now let's delete the faces that are not needed. Select the edges, hit extrude, and use vertex snap to close this hole. Now go to edit mesh, merge. Now these two edges are not needed. Let's select those and delete. So we have now created a 3D model out of a simple 2D plan. Now let's see how this can be useful.
But why should I be working in real world scale? Number one, when a team works on a single project, it makes no sense if every member of the team has his own scale. The only solution for this problem is to work in a universal scale, which apparently is a real world scale. Number two, the lights in V-Ray and Mental Ray are configured to work with real world scale. The 30 watt downlight, for instance, which when placed in a scene that is modeled to real world scale, has the same effect just as it has in the real world scale. Number 3. Good lighting and proper scaling of model gives you a good rendering. Number 4. Implementation of your visualization becomes easier if you model in real world scale. Hope you find this tutorial useful. If you want to contact, visit my blog. The link is in the description below. And don't forget to like or unlike the video accordingly. Thanks for watching.